Hello everyone, welcome back to my insect pests or crops lecture series. In this lecture, that is lecture number 5, we will be discussing the pests of cruciferous vegetables. The cruciferous vegetables are also called coal crops, which belongs to family Brassicaceae. The important crops which are belongs to this Brassicaceae family includes cabbage, cauliflower, turnip, broccoli, radish, beetroot, and many other crops, in fact. And coal crops are widely grown throughout the world, both in temperate and tropical countries. And many of the insects are widely distributed and causes very serious losses to these crops. In fact, one of the important pests called DBM, diamond back moth, is one of the serious pests which causes heavy loss, especially in cabbage and cauliflower. And it is one of the insect which receives highest insecticides, different types of insecticides, and as a result, in fact, coal crops receive very high insecticides, and many times lot of residue will remain in the crops, in the products, and hence pose a very high risk of health. And hence we need to think of integrated pest management strategies when it comes to the very important pest like diamond back moth. So we'll take one by one the important pests. So we'll start with the foliage feeders, which includes diamond back moth, Lutella xylostella, I was telling you, which is one of the very important pests, in fact. Leaf weber, Crocidolomia pavonina, cabbage head borer, Ellula andalis, cabbage butterfly, Pieris brassicae, mustard sawfly, Athelia lugens proxima. And in checking pests, cabbage aphid, Bravicorine brassicae, and painted bug, Bagrada hilaris. So these are the pests we'll discuss in detail. So we'll take one by one. We'll start with the diamond back moth, Flutella xylostella, which belongs to family Flutellidae. In fact, if you refer world literature, it is considered as belongs to family Viponematidae. Okay, so but it is now under the family Flutellidae. And in fact, this species, Flutella xylostella, attacks almost all the coal crops. So majorly cabbage, cauliflower, radish, alcohol. And if you look at the distribution, you can see here, distributed throughout the world, except in few countries of Africa and Russia. This insect has been reported throughout the world, both in temperate and tropical countries. Okay, so one of the very important reasons that it attacks all the cruciferous crops is actually presence of glucosinolates, okay, which is actually sulfur containing secondary plant compound, and which attracts the diamond back moth. Of course, many other pests which are actually depending on these crops, in fact, get attracted to glucosinolates released by the host plants. So this species, in fact, originated in South Africa or East Asia, and as I was telling, it is distributed throughout the world at present. And why it is actually called diamond back moth? Okay, diamond back moth. So when you use the word back, it is almost always referred to either thorax or abdomen. Okay, so here in this case, when the insect actually, in the sitting posture, you'll find these diamond shaped markings. Hence, it is actually called diamond back moth. So if that is the case, why are how actually these diamond shaped markings appears on the back of this moth? In fact, these diamond shaped are the whitish or pale yellowish colored marking is actually found on the anal margin of the forewings, not exactly on the thorax or abdomen. As I was telling, it is actually found on the anal margin of the forewings when they actually sit. Okay, when they brought together both of pairs of wings, forewings together. So this type of diamond shaped markings appears on the back. Hence, it is actually called diamond back moth. So this is the sitting posture. You can clearly see this diamond shaped markings. Hence, it earned the name diamond back moth. So if you look at the biology of diamond back moth, it lays up to 57 eggs singly on the undersurface of leaves along the vines, especially prefers to lay the eggs along the vines. And it takes about 4 to 5 days for hatching, and larval period is about 13 to 21 days. The larva is greenish with short, thin ears arising on the body. Okay, very small larva, measures about 1 centimeter or so, but a very deadliest pest, in fact. And pupal period takes about 7 to 9 days, and in fact pupa can be very easily recognized. So if you visit a any coal crop field, you can clearly recognize this pupa, which is actually covered with thin loose mesh of silken cocoon, very clear. So this is larva, this is pupa, and the adult with a diamond shaped markings. So to become an egg to adult, it takes about 24 to 35 days. So this is the total life cycle. If you look at the nature of damage, the early instars in fact just scrape the leaves. So as a result, whitish patches appears on the leaves. Whereas later instars feed extensively by making biting holes. Very clear, you can see here, more number of larvae, they actually create holes, and the growth and development of the plant get affected. And the whole plant, in fact, will consist of a lot of holes that actually fetches very less price in the market and are not suitable for marketing and consumption. So we'll see the management of DBM. So one of the very serious pests, in fact, as I was telling, it receives highest quantity of insecticides and has developed resistance to most of the insecticides with the different modes of action and dens. Scientists around the world continually working on, researching on developing management of this worst pest. Okay, so the management should be initiated in the nursery itself. Okay, raise the seedlings in insect-proof nylon mesh or under net house so that the colonization in the nursery itself can be avoided. Okay, if they colonize in the nursery itself, when the seedlings are transplanted, so definitely the inoculum spread, so and leads to heavy infestation in the main field. So before transplanting, so seedlings may be sprayed with indoxacarb, novaluran, or memantine benzoate at the concentration mentioned here. And the day before transplanting, the insecticide may be sprayed so that whatever the inoculum is there, that can be completely killed and seedlings can be transplanted. Whereas in the main field, one of the very important measure which was actually developed from the scientists of Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, wherein they suggested growing bold seeded Indian mustard, which has to be sown 12 to 15 days preceding planting cabbage. So before transplanting cabbage, so the mustard has to be sown, for every 25 day to 25 rows of cabbage, so that, whatever the colonization which starts occurring on the cabbage can be diverted to this trap crop. The reason being, so this DBM prefers to feed on mustard than the cabbage. So mustard is a susceptible host that can be used as trap crop. So that attracts up to 80 to 90% of DBM. As a result, the quantity of the insecticide required to manage DBM on this cabbage can be reduced. Okay. So whatever the DBM larvae or the adult which comes and lays the eggs can be killed by spraying insecticide like carta hydrochloride only on the mustard, so that the quantity of insecticide applied on the main crop can be reduced. So when it comes to biological control, so very important aspect in the management of DBM in order to reduce the insecticides. Okay, so fungal pathogen, entomum pathogenic fungus called Beveria bassiana based commercial formulation can be used. Of course, many companies have developed Beveria bassiana based formulation. One such commercial formulation is actually Mycojal, developed by Pest Control India Limited. So depending on the commercial availability, that can be sprayed. So this actually, in fact, use of entomum pathogen nematodes or any biopesticides, in fact, will have a very less negative effect on the parasitoids, which includes one of the very important natural parasitoids called Cotacea plutella, which belongs to family Braconidae, and also Diadigma group, Diadigma semiclasm or Diadigma fenestralis, which belongs to family Cnomanidae. So both of them works very well under the field condition. They parasitize the DBM. So hence, so biocontrol should be popularized or encouraged so that the quantity of insecticides applied can be reduced. So similarly, the application of 4% NSKE, which can be prepared by the farmers themselves, and it has to be applied during primordial or initiation stage. In case of cabbage or cauliflower, it takes about 20 to 25 days for primordial initiation stage. During that time, the NSKE can be applied. Okay. So it may be also you can consider use of neem soap, which is again developed by Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, or Pangaea soap, that can be applied at the rate of 1%. So still, many of the insecticides have been tested, evaluated, and are recommended against diamondback moth, which includes indoxacarb, 0.5 ml per liter, spinosad, 1 ml per liter of water, fluphenoxazin, 10% DC at the rate of 0.8 ml, chlorantraniliprole, okay, 0.4 ml per liter of water. So like flubendiamide, 0.1 ml, imamectin benzoate, 0.4 gram per liter, like that number of insecticides have been recommended. So only thing, farmers has to be very careful that they shouldn't alternate the insecticide. They should not continuously use same insecticide and again and again, so that so we can avoid resistant buildup against a particular group of insecticides. Okay, so still now this insect has developed resistance to many of these insecticides, especially in India. So hence, so you can also think of using BT formulations. Okay, commercially available BT formulations like Delphin, many other insecticides are available. So that actually avoids, as if the mode of action is different as a result. So even for killing, managing insecticide resistant population, you can think of using BT formulations. So I was talking about the very important natural parasitoids. So even people tried mass multiplication, developing mass multiplication techniques, which can be released at the rate of 40,000 adults per acre. So at the rate of 8,000 adults per release, which includes Cotacea flotella. So both of them, and another one is Diadigma semiclasm. Both of them are in fact solitary endoparasitoids, which actually parasitize the larvae of diamondback moth. So here you can clearly see the larvae of DBM larvae, which is died, and followed by the pupa of Cotacea flotella. Okay, so adult emerge, it goes actually in search of larvae and it lays the eggs inside the caterpillar. So we'll move to next pest, leaf webber, Crocidolomia peonoena, belongs to family Crambidae. So you can very clearly identify this larvae of leaf webber. So yellowish green, okay, five fine yellowish lines running longitudinally from head to last abdominal segment. And you can see the ears arising from the warts. Okay, very clearly can identify. Whereas the adults are brownish with cream markings here and there. So very, two markings are very clear on the middle region of the forewings. So that's how we can identify the larvae and adult of Crocidolomia peonoena. Coming to biology, so it lays about 40 to 100 overlapping flat eggs. Okay, they'll be arranged like this, flat eggs, which takes about 3 to 5 days. And larvae has red head and green body, as I told. It takes about 24 to 27 days during summer, short larval period, whereas during winter, it takes longer duration. And pupation occurs on the leaves itself, on the foliage itself. It takes about 14 to 20 days. Pupa is cylindrical, olive green to light brown. So it takes about 24 to 35 days from egg to adult. Okay, so that is the biology of Crocidolomia peonoena. So you can see the damage, the early instars, in fact, when the overlapping eggs actually comes out and the early instars are gregarious, you can see they just scrape the leaves, they skeletonize, whereas the later instar stops moving and they actually completely damage the foliage. That's how you can see lot of excreta accumulated there itself. Okay, so webs and feed on the foliage. So how do you manage this leaf webber? So you need to remove and destroy the webbed leaves with caterpillar. Early instars, especially gregarious, they can be hand collected and destroyed. Or else you can go for insecticide like deltamethrin, which is applied at the rate of 0.5 ml per liter of water, or padan or carthophytochloride, which has to be applied at the rate of 2 ml per liter of water. Okay, so insecticides application generally started during around 20 days because during that time, the primordial initiation stage takes place in case of coal crops, especially in cabbage and cauliflower. So as I was mentioning that bold-seeded Indian mustard is widely used as a trap cropping system for attracting both leaf webber as well as DBM. So in fact, about 10 to 12 days in advance, you need to go for sowing this bold-seeded Indian mustard for every 24 rows of cabbage. So then you should go for transplanting cabbage. So whatever the DBM or the leaf webber which are attracted to field, they are actually diverted to mustard, and so that the damage on the main crop is reduced. Not only that, the insecticide received by these crops is out, gets also reduced. As a result, the residue remains on these crops gets reduced. So that is the idea behind use of this trap cropping system. So coming to next pest, cabbage head borer, Yellula andalis, belongs to family Crambidae. So very easily you can recognize, you can see the full grown larva is grayish yellow with 7 purplish lines, okay, purplish brown longitudinal stripes running from head to last abdominal segment. Okay, clearly it can be identified. So, and the adult is grayish brown moth with wavy gray markings. Okay, hindwings, whereas hindwings are actually pale the skin color. That's how you can recognize this head borer. In fact, early instars, though they mince the leaves, as a result, you can see the white papery skeletons filled with a lot of excreta. So, in fact, it earned the name head borer, the reason being, so later instars actually bore into the stem or stalks or the heads. That's how it earned the name head borer. So, do you manage the Yellula andalis? Collect and destroy mechanically the caterpillars in the early stage of attack. Okay, so as we'll find these webbings, and then go for spraying PT. So, with my experience, so in fact, whatever the insecticide we apply for the management of diamond back moth, that itself is enough to manage most of the pests of now cabbage or cauliflower. That's how this DBM is in fact very serious. So, unless and until the farmers actually, you know, pest managers comes across any of these specific damage symptoms, then only you can target the Yellula andalis. Otherwise, many times the management aspects taken for DBM is enough to take control, manage most of the other pests. Next pest, cabbage butterfly, Pieris brassicae. You can clearly recognize the yellowish colored eggs, which are flask shaped, about 1 mm long and yellowish in color. So very clearly you can recognize, whereas the early instars are gregarious, whereas later instars you can see, so they are bluish green in color, velvety bluish green in color, with a lot of black spots, yellow dorsal and lateral stripes you can see here, okay, covered with a lot of white ears. Okay, very characteristic coloration in fact. And pupa is in fact now chrysalis, green with the black spots and dots, you can see very clear. And adults are actually snow white colored with 4 rings with black distal margins, okay, very clear. So belongs to family Pieridae. Okay, famously known as cabbage butterfly. Okay, so again, as I was telling, the early instars are gregarious, they can be uncollected and destroyed, and can go for BT spray. So number of parasitoids, one of the known parasitoid is again Potassia glomeratus, another species of Braconid, or so you can go for spraying, you know, Melathion or cut off hydrochloride. So that takes care of this pest. Another defoliator pest found on coal crops is mustard sawfly. So belongs to family Tenthredinidae, Athelia, Lugenes, Praxima, belongs to family, belongs to order Hymenoptera. So very important thing is that you can see here Hymenoptera. If I say Hymenoptera, mostly we think of most parasitoids. Okay, so one of the Hymenoptera is actually pest, very serious pest in fact. Okay, especially in few areas, especially in temperate zones. So this pest is very serious on many of the coal crops, especially radish, beetroot and other crops. Okay, so you can see at first look, these grubs look like caterpillars. Okay, so we know that the difference between caterpillar and a grub of a Hymenoptera. So adults, again, it looks like small moth. Okay, but you can clearly see this, you know, the arrangement of the wings are actually placed above the abdomen at rest. And this is mainly distributed in India, and also it is reported from Japan. Okay, so attacks mustard, rapeseed, cabbage, cauliflower, and many other crops. So you can see here, adults are dark, you have got dark head. Okay, orange colored abdomen, very clear, and translucent smoky wings with a lot of black veins. So another diagram you are seeing on the dorsal side, okay, with black veins. Lays about 30 to 35 eggs. With the help of a very well-developed slit-like ovipositor, you know, it has got a lot of spines like. With the help of, in fact, it opens the leaf lamina and lays the eggs. Okay, so that's why it's actually called sawfly. The reason being, it possesses saw-like ovipositor. With the help of, actually, it makes slits and lays the eggs between the leaf lamina. And the caterpillar you can see here, okay, are the grubs. Okay, so it looks like caterpillar, in fact. So measures about 16 to 20 mm long, greenish black in color. So they look like and behave like caterpillars, but have 8 pairs of prolegs without pochettes. Okay, so the difference between the caterpillar and a grub is that, Hymenoptera and grub is that, the in case of Sympaeton Hymenoptera, we find this now prolegs, but in fact they lack crochets. You can clearly see the damage by Athalia lucens. They completely bite the leaves and defoliate. So management, you know, say especially during dawn and dusk, they are active and they come out and they start feeding on the leaves. During that time, they can be ant picked and destroyed, or if necessary, only when the population increases, you can think of insecticide like Melathion. Otherwise, as I was mentioning, the most of the insecticides which we use against diamond back moth is enough to manage other pests of coal crops. So those were the pests, defoliator pests. So now we think of now two major pests, which are actually the sucking pests, which one of it is cabbage aphid Bravicorhine brassicae. You can clearly see the colonization of these nymphs and adults. So very large number of nymphs and adults actually now stays both in upper and lower leaf surface and sucks the sap. Both nymphs and adults sucks the sap, and they excrete large quantity of honeydew, which actually is found or smeared on the leaf surface, okay, and makes it unsuitable for marketing and consumption. Very tough. Many times the damage may not be serious, but presence of this honeydew itself is actually very problematic for marketing. Okay, fetches very less price in the market or unsuitable for consumption. You need to literally wash it before selling it. Many times it happens. So the plants may express yellowing, crinkling and cupping, distorted primordia, presence of white cast skin. You can see as the large number of nymphs will be there, they molt, and now we find a lot of cast skin which is actually falling on the leaf surface or on the plant surface. Okay, again, naturally, one of the well-known parasitoids which is reported is Dyrrhachial rapae. In fact, the parasitization of Dyrrhachial rapae leads to mummification of the aphids. You can very clearly the cuticle actually gets hardened, but the parasite actually comes out of by making a small hole. So Dyrrhachial rapae, very important parasitoid against Bravicorhine brassicae. So when it comes to management, install yellow sticky traps, 12 number per hectare, that attracts the winged adults. As soon as the aphid infestation occurs, you identify, so such part has to be collected and destroyed. So again, you can go for biopesticide like neem oil or NSKE, neem soap, which are available. So that actually takes care of the population of aphids. So only when it is necessary, you can think of synthetic insecticides like imidacloprid or acephate. So another, the pest which is widely distributed again is painted bug. Okay, Bagrada hilaris. It earned the name painted because of its coloration. You can see now black coloration with orange and whitish patch running between in the middle of thorax and abdomen, number of spots. Okay, that's how it's called actually painted bug. Bagrada hilaris belongs to family Pentatomida. Again, it attacks most of the coal crops. So they suck this up, and as a result, you will find the whitish patches, which actually later leads to wilting and withering of that. So many times, so because of the sucking activity, the secondary invasion of the bacteria and fungi occurs, and the whole plant actually express withering and wilting symptom. Yeah, so those are the major pests of cruciferous crops. If you want to just list the minor pests, our Spodoptera litora, tobacco cutworm, is again, pests on cruciferous crops as well. Highly polyphagous, cabbage semilooper, trichoplusiani, you can see the movement of this semilooper. Cutworm, Agrotis cypsilon, again, very serious polyphagous pest, active at night. Then flea beetles. So here and there it is considered as a major pest, but in most parts of India, it is actually a minor pest. Philotrita, Cruciferae, Philotrita, Cotonica, Monolepta, Signeta, like that, there are a number of flea beetles belongs to family Chrysomelidae attacks, cruciferous crops. Okay, so in fact, for most of the pests of cabbage, so before that, so one of the very important thing to be considered is that the insecticide red residue which remains in the cabbage. In fact, I read somewhere that better to or prefer use of cabbage or cauliflower which has insects on the plant. Okay, or on the cabbage or cauliflower. If insects are there on the plant, that can be directly used for preparing dishes. But if the insects are not there, that indicates that it probably has received insecticide. As a result, insects are not there on that part of the plant or on the cabbage or cauliflower. So that indicates that cabbage or cauliflowers receives very high amount of insecticides. As a result, it has many times it will have a lot of residues inside. So when you consume the cabbage or cauliflower which has got a lot of insecticides, that has got a very high negative effect on human beings. So that's why a lot of research organizations are trying to develop integrated pest management or the biopesticide management based management strategies. One such strategy is use of IHR's neem seed powder pellets, NSPP, at the rate of 30 gram per liter. In fact, they developed by utilizing whole neem powder, a polymer, photoprotecting agents, preservatives, and stabilizers. They have a patent on this now product, and that can be mixed at the rate of 30 gram per liter and sprayed. That actually gives protection, especially against DBM and as well as aphids. Okay, so that can be used as insecticide-free product, so that the effect on human beings can be reduced. Okay, so there are many other biopesticides available, so which actually reduces the amount of insecticides sprayed on these fall crops. So I'll end this lecture with a few questions. Important natural parasites recorded on DBM, I listed two, so try to go on. Find it out. What should be the sowing methodology for trap cropping mustard with cabbage or cauliflower? So I was telling that mustard is used as trap cropping. What is the methodology of sowing? What is the present name of AVRDC? So AVRDC is the one organization which is working on various vegetables, developing increasing the productivity as well as for developing the plant protection technologies. So what is its present name, where it is actually located? Okay, so I'll end this lecture. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, you can ask below or you can email me as well. Thank you very much.